Weed and weapons don't mix, but what about a concealed handgun permit and a medical marijuana card? That takes us to this woman in Oregon. Her name is Cynthia Willis. She's fighting for her right to have both, not use them simultaneously, but to have them both. Police took away her gun permit after learning that she used medically prescribed marijuana to treat arthritis pain and muscle spasms. The cops cite the 1968, let me repeat, the 1968 United States Gun Control Act, which prohibits selling weapons to drug addicts.
We're not a bunch of gun nuts.
No, you're not a bunch of gun nuts. They say that includes medical marijuana users. But the woman and three other plaintiffs in this case say their state gun rights trump the federal law. And they've taken their case to Oregon's Supreme Court. So we will take it to our legal panel. The criminal defense attorney, Randy Zellin, in the House. Former prosecutor, Tom Kniff, also IE. What say you?
I think that this is a blatant violation of Cynthia Willis's rights to equal protection under the law. Owning a handgun, whether we support the Second Amendment or not, it's there. It's a fundamental right. Anytime the state is passing legislation that's going to infringe on an individual's fundamental rights, they need to show a compelling state interest, and they need to show that there weren't other less restrictive means to deal with this situation. What are the less restrictive means? You don't have to put a blanket ban on her right to possess a handgun. You say, look, you're a medical marijuana user. You can't go to the range when you're high.
Right.
But it doesn't mean that you can't have a gun at all, period.
Mr. Z.
Not right.
Counselor?
I love Tom.
Oh, well.
This is why I hate lawyers.
It's always bad when it starts
with
that.
Can we inject a little bit of common sense into this discussion? Who in their right mind could actually argue that guns and pot go together?
She didn't argue that.
Somebody smarter than me said two great tastes that go together. I mean, you got to be kidding me. Should we wait and find out?
What happens in the commercial stays in the commercial.
But wait a second. Let's not forget something. Marijuana, it's still illegal. It's a Schedule I controlled substance, which means the federal government says it's highly addictive. We don't give someone a gun permit who we know is going to be smoking pot. Should we have somebody next to her making sure she's not smoking and then going to the range? Common sense, people.
Randy, if someone has a prescription for Oxycontin, should he have to surrender his gun permit, or should you say that you can't take the Oxycontin when you're going out hunting quail?
Oxycontin is legal. Marijuana is not.
It is legal in Oregon, and you need a prescription to get Oxycontin the same way.
It's an exception. It's illegal.
Under federal law,
it's illegal.
It's illegal, but it's not prosecuted in states that allow medical marijuana.
But how about a little thing called the supremacy clause?
It's illegal to drink Budweiser while driving your car.
But it is not per se illegal to drink Budweiser.
But it's
illegal
under those circumstances.
Not in Oregon.
So why wouldn't you say that it could be illegal to shoot weapons while you're stoned out of your mind?
It's too late.
But it's not illegal to smoke weapons.
Smoke weapons. There you go. I like that. You're right, Shep. You cannot smoke a weapon. I agree.
Seriously.
Should we wait? Why wait until it's too late? And there's a tragedy.
If you use that logic, then to someone who possesses a gun permit, should there be a blanket ban on them ever possessing alcohol?
Well, what happens if someone gets arrested on a drug charge? Isn't it possible that they could lose their gun permit?
Yes, but we're not talking about illegal contact. The federal gun law prevents addicts. There's no allegation that she's an addict. And it prevents illegal users. Under Oregon law, she's an authorized user. That's the difference. Like someone using Oxycontin, or like a Southern gentleman from Mississippi having a little major bar
going out to shoot some game.
Shooting with a guy? We gotta go.
No, I wouldn't.
Go shooting with a guy drinking Budweiser? Ooh.
How about smoking pot?
History says I've done that before. Gone shooting with a guy.
Not smoking pot.
Well, you know, a lot of people smoke pot. I don't know. There's a lot of weed out there, Randy.